Let us start with the recitation of Om. Close your eyes. 5 times you will do it. And do it from your heart. Okay? Chapter by chapter now. So we discussed in chapter 1, there are two words, dharma and karma. What is dharma? And I shared with you, dharma is the value system on which this whole creation is set up. It's the article of association of this creation, created by Brahma, who is the creator of this universe. And karma is the action. If our action is based upon dharma, no problem. We are all happy. We are all celestial. We are all spiritual. But we don't do that. First of all, we are not aware and we don't apply. That is the limitation and problem of all of us. So that's why they say that man is a product of practice. First of all, I must have the awareness what I have to practice. If I am practicing wrong thing, in due course I will become a wrong person. But I will be boasting that I have been practicing. So practice must be based upon knowledge. What type of practice? Which is the right practice? So once I do that, I understand that, then life is easy. Life is very, very easy, but we are so expert at making it difficult because we don't follow the rules, and that is the problem. All this spiritual literature, Vedas, Puranas, Upanishads, they are directing us day in, day out, shouting from the rooftop for the last many, many thousand years, please, oh man, don't do that. But we don't listen. We make our own rules through the prism of our ego, and we look at differently. So that is the problem. So according to chapter 1, dharma and karma, it is a flip coin. So I have to understand this concept very clearly. And it's easy. It's very easy. Dharma is a value system. And the first value is non-violence. Don't hurt people through speech, physical violence, mental violence, vocal violence. Don't do that. But we do that. We do that. Until and unless I stop it, whatever I do, it is not qualitative. But in our real life, we are looking for quality. In corporate world, the best word these days is the quality. You've got to be qualitative. Time management comes under quality. So quality means that my actions should be qualitative based upon qualitative thinking. So that is what the value system is. Second value system is help others. These are simple rules. I'm not making up. You know it, but we don't apply it. We don't apply it. Help others. And your progress is hidden in the progress of others. Hold this formula and apply it. You are progressing, it's okay. But what about the others? Share their wisdom, that knowledge, that ability, that resources which boosted your progress. Apply that and extend your hand to others who are the weaker section of society, your friends, your relatives. Apply that formula, even in your home. Our relationship with our wives and wives' relationship with the husband is so fragile these days. Little thing ignites the relationship. Why? Because they don't understand the life. The person who is with me for many, many years, throughout my life, I don't understand that person. And then I talk of world peace. What about the home peace? What is the peace in the kitchen? What is the peace in the bedroom, in the living room, with the kids? And then I go out and talk about the world peace. Are you kidding me? It will not apply. So the idea is, the moment I step out of my home, I should be peaceful. And then when you interact with people, you will make them peaceful. If you are agitated, excited, the moment you step out, it is contagious. You will make people excited. If you are boss, your employees will have a hard time, I tell you. And you have seen those bosses. They have a fight with the wife at home, and they are screwing up everybody, 20, 30 employees under him, working under him. Nobody dares to go into his cubicle. But there are other supervisors, managers, directors, human resources. They calm you down. They calm you down. Because they know the technique. They know the technique through training and through awareness. That this is one of their job to make the employee at ease. And that cannot be done, that cannot be achieved until I am peaceful. So these are the rules of the creation, I am saying. You can call it a behavioral science, whatever word you can, but in the dharma, this is a dharma. Don't do that. Life is easy. Life is very easy. You will get up like a rose. You will be always peaceful. You will be always laughing inside. The other day, last year, I shared with you that Lord Krishna is seated in the heart of everybody. And he's a photographer. He's taking your picture all the time. But we don't smile. Because we don't have the profound conviction that he is here. First of all, I have to develop that profound conviction that he is here. And now, conduct yourself. We think, no, he may be seven skies high somewhere, or in that temple, or near Pujaris. No, he's with you, with me. But I have to convince myself. Once I get it right, that Lord Krishna is seated here, my whole conduct will change. I will be a totally revolutionized person, different person. I will be smiling because I am being photographed. Now people have lost the art of smiling. Look at people. There are so many concerns, so many worries. Aisa na ho jai, waisa na ho jai, bachon ka kya hoga, uska kya hoga. As if he or she is the owner of this whole world. No. Nobody cares about you. You die today. Immediately the adjustment will be made. And if you come back after 2 months, you are the most unwanted person in that household. Because they have made the adjustments. Wo kahenge ji kya karne aaye. But still we don't get it right. Still we think it is me who is running the show. That is not a dharma. And since that is not a dharma, my karma is also defective because I am basing my action on this thought. So the idea is that try to practice at your own level, in your own little home. I also shared with you that man is the king of his home. Man's kingdom is his home. Shakespeare said. We believe Shakespeare. We don't believe Bhagavad Gita. We don't believe Bhagavad Gita. Who is the Shakespeare? He is a man like you and me. But since we were born slave, India was not free, most of the people at that time, your parents or my parents, we are the sons of slaves. And our slave mentality is still there. Anything in English, you believe. Anything in other vernacular language, we don't believe. So the idea is, it's a very powerful message, that base your karma on dharma. And your life is very easy. So this was the chapter first. And then at the end of chapter first and in the beginning of chapter second, Lord Krishna gave a very innovative idea that we are not the bodies, we are living in the bodies. And I will correlate this in our day-to-day life, how it will change you. It's a bombshell thinking that we are not bodies, we are living in the bodies. What does it mean? Nainam chindanti shastrani, nainam dahati pavaka, na chainam kledhyantyapu, na shochati maruta. Dehino asmin yatha dehe kaumarum javanam jara, tatha dehantir praptir dhiras tatrana muhati. Ashochyan anvashochas tvam pragyavadhanch bhashte gatasun gatasushamch nano shochanti pandita. That we are not the bodies. This body is made of five elements which are available right here. Earth, air, fire, ether and water. And we have to return this. When we die, these elements merge there. You cannot take it. You are taken from here, you have to give it back. So if we are not bodies, then what we are? There are three more elements. Five I counted just now. Then is the mind, intellect and ego. And then the soul, the spirit. So it's a house, edifice on nine elements. Since I am not the body, this body is on lease. We took the lease from Lord Krishna. You have to return it. It's just like you're leasing a car. When you lease a car, you have to take care of reasonable, that is the word, reasonable care, and you have to return it. But if you abuse it or misuse it, the dealer will not take your car. You will be stuck with that. So normal wear and tear is accepted. But abuse and misuse is not accepted. I am talking about the car. This body is a car. You are the driver. At the end of this day, you have to return this body from whom you took the lease. And the body will be accepted, the lease will be accepted at the termination only if reasonable care has been taken. But if I have abused it, misused it, I will be suffering. I will end up in the nursing home. I may be in a coma. I may be suffering from many, many diseases because I have misused it and abused it. This concept, if I meditate on this thought, that I have to return this body, my whole daily routine will change. I will be more qualitative what I eat. Does not matter, vegetarian, non-vegetarian, that is your choice. But you will be qualitative. What I eat, what I speak, what is my speech? I am hurting people or I am uplifting them? I am making them negative and dejected or I am making them positive and uplifted? Am I doing that? What is my thoughts all the time, most of the time, what are my predominant thoughts in a day? I shared with you that one time I circulated one white paper to the audience and I asked them to write only 10 predominant thoughts of the day. And rightly so, within 10 minutes I got it back. Nobody wrote spirituality. There are other concerns. Children, home, wife, boss, job, other things. Nobody wrote that I want to know what is my mission on this planet, why what I am doing, because at the end of the day everything is zeroed out. We leave everything here. If that is true, that in that list of my thinking, there must be some space. But nobody wrote. Because we don't think. We don't think that way. So until and unless I put a top priority, then this is also a mission. Job I have to do to live on this planet. Livelihood. But at the same time, there are bigger missions, bigger things, global things, universal things. And man is the perfection of creation. And it is expected of him or her that in this human form, which is the apex of creation, beyond that there is no creation which is so perfect. And we don't do that. So, we are missing the point. Our priorities are upside down. Put this at the top. The other things will follow. We are thinking the other way around. We put so much emphasis on job. But if I give you now an idea that Lord Krishna is seated in your heart all the time and you are being watched, you are being photographed, what I will do when I am sitting in my office and doing my job, I am not looking for my job, that for my supervisor. My supervisor is here. So I should not dare to do dishonest work. Because I am being photographed. But I should have the conviction. Conviction. So if I do this way, that Lord Krishna is watching me all the time, my quality of work will be par excellent. Par excellent. I will get my raises more than anybody else. Because I am working for him, who is the boss of all the bosses. But I should have the conviction. It is not a theoretical thing. It has to be practiced. It has to be practiced. It has to be practiced. Once I get it right, it is very easy. It is cost effective. There is no cost involved. There is no workshop involved. There is no training involved. It is just to convince yourself that Lord Krishna is here. So, I gave you the idea that we are not the bodies, but we are living in the bodies. So if I am not body, then whatever I am doing, it is an acting. It is like Amitabh Bachchan movie. When we say that this movie is very good, what we are saying actually? that this actor, who is the hero, he did outstanding acting in those costumes at the stage. Whatever the scene was, he was par excellence. We are exactly like that. But foolishly, we think that it is not acting. And that is a human tragedy. We don't think we are acting. Because when the acting is finished, Amitabh Bachchan's scene is finished, he wants to go home, he has to leave all his costumes with which he was acting behind the stage. Right? He does not go like, I mean, emperor to Jai Bahadri. No, he becomes a human being like you and me. He is wearing his normal clothes. The same concept is applicable. That we, what are we are doing? Develop the thinking that you are acting. Once you understand that acting, then your ego is subdued. You are doing for others. Actor is doing for others. Movie is for others. He is not a part of that movie, whatever movie he is in. He is just acting. So, let us take, suppose I am acting, I pretend I am acting. I am devoid of any stress. Because whatever the movie is, Amitabh Bachchan is not affected because he is going home fresh. He will be sipping a coffee with his family. But in the movie, he might have done 20 murders. So what? He was acting. Right? Apply that. Think mentally that I am acting. And who is watching? Who is the audience? We are all the witnesses of our own acting. So if I am, my acting is perfect, like I am now sharing with you the thoughts, and mentally I am thinking I am acting, I am giving you the best performance because it is acting. But after 10 minutes I will be laughing, talking with you like a normal person. So once I develop this art and technique and practice it and make it perfect, then on a daily basis, when you go home, right, your wife, think the same way in the movie. That is a scene and you are talking to an individual to whom you love, and develop that attitude to communicate with those individuals who are near and dear to you, around you. The home will be very peaceful. Very, very peaceful. But we don't do that. We think it is the reality. But this world is not real. It is changeable. Everything is changing. Everything is moving. All planetary system, whole space, ecology, billions of stars and galaxies and nebulas, including people like you and me, 7.3 billion people, everything is changing. So if everything is changing, don't hold anything. Don't hold anything now. Let it go. But we are holding, we are very expert, we don't let it go. When I get old, I know one day all my wealth, all my possessions I have to leave behind. Now I start thinking of making a will. First of all, that wealth is not mine. It belongs to the society. Society gave me. I went to college. College is society. I went to school. School is a society. I didn't make the school. I just went to the school. So I used all the resources of the society to become successful. And whatever I gained, it belonged to society. So if I think that way, then there's no point in making the will. Will means you are holding it now. You think that it should not go. But it doesn't belong to you. That's a sinful thinking, defective thinking. It looks weird in this materialistic world, but spiritually I am giving you the insight. This is a better way, because that will levitate you through your thinking. You will be thinking differently. Once you have a periscope, one is kaleidoscope. If you look through kaleidoscope, just move it, there are billions of different combinations. Life is like that. You move from here to here, because the whole thing is moving. It is not you are moving. When you go on a cruise, let us say you are going on a cruise for 10 days. Every facility is there. Boarding, lodging, plenty, tons of food, lot of people. It is a moving city. But the ship is moving, right? It is not at one place. So while we are doing all those things which we are doing here, we do those things on the ship, and the ship is moving. We never think, while we come back to New York, that New York is moving too. It is a big ship. This globe is a big ship. 7.3 billion people are moving around, making houses and this and that. Cars are running. Lot of bhidbhadaka. But it is moving like a ship. Think that way. That will release you from your petty thinking, petty worries. So this concept, this is related to the acting part now I am talking, which is the basis of that I am not a body, I am living in the body. So simple. But it's very hard to digest. It is very extremely hard to translate into your day-to-day doings. We think that we are the real people. We are not real people. We are shadows. Shadows. 90% of our body is liquid. 90%. Real water and blood and everything else. Even your brain, it is a liquid thing. Wrapped around a skeleton with the skin, and we say, oh, I am very powerful. I am very intelligent. Okay, say it. But think this way also, that you are not the real person. You are not the real person. Once you develop that, your worries disappear. You become the visitor. There is a big difference between the owner and the visitor. If I visit your home, I am the visitor, you are the owner. You have all the worries. I have no worry. I just visit and after 10 minutes I leave the house. But you are staying there. But if you think, if the owner of the house thinks that I am also a visitor, before me millions of people have bought this house and sold this house and bought this house and sold this property. And I am one of them. If I think that way, my worries disappear because we don't think that way. We think that this is my house, so oh, this is my problem. No. Somebody is ready to buy that. We are all living in the apartments. We are very happy. Everybody was in the one bedroom. Then we got two bedrooms. We were a little more happy. Now you have 15 rooms, big rooms, lot of property, happiness, forget about it. What happened? We thought bigger house, bigger property, bigger space will give us more satisfaction. No. It was a mirage. Everybody socially thinks when you all sit together, oh, 20 years back, you know, we used to sit together and we used to do like that, we used to do that. No, nobody talks those things. Because people are not believing in the concept that we are all actors on this planet. So, since my body, I am not the body, I am living in the body, this body has to give back sooner or later. Nobody knows the terms of the lease. So, if I have to give it back to the dealer, dealer is Lord Krishna. He gave you the body, you have to return it to him. But return it to him with a reasonable care, wear and tear, and he will accept it. Otherwise, I will pay a heavy price through diseases, through other limitations, lot of concerns and worries because I misuse this body. So the idea is, in chapter 2, this is the very revolutionary idea that we are not bodies, we are living in the bodies. And I should be very clear, most of our worries are relating to the bodies. 95% of our resources are spent on the body, outer body. Inner, which is a real thing, we don't have time, we don't invest anything. If there is a Bhagavad Gita class, after 30 minutes everybody is choked up. Let's get up and go. If Lata Mangeshkar or Shah Rukh Khan comes, they do dancing and singing. You can sit for hours, hours and hours. So if that is the way we are leading lives, nothing is free. No lunch is free. Then it is a package deal. If you are leading that type of life, lot of worries, lot of concerns. And our backs are broken. We lose the concept of living in the present. Most of the time under this concept, we are either living in the past or in the future. We have no awareness of the present. Now this is the Bhagavad Gita class. I don't know how many we are here mentally. Physically, yes, we are sitting here. But why I am talking and sharing thoughts on Srimad Bhagavad Gita, mentally how many people are here? That is up to you, because nobody can go inside. But that's a technique. So if I am sitting in Bhagavad Gita class and I am in the past, what I am doing? I am creating trouble for me. Past is dead. It's a dead weight. If 1 ton weight is sitting on my back and I am moving, I am in trouble. Better, sooner I let that weight go and I walk erect, straight, weightless. But we don't do that. First of all, we are not aware. There's a lot of weight of the past. And then we don't do it. So who is doing all these things? You and me and everybody else. So through this awareness, if we practice that there is a better way, there is a better window through which you will see a better light, better perspective of life. That window which is you. We should not close the windows of our mind. Mind should be open. Fresh air must come. And fresh air can come only through awareness. Through awareness. The more aware I am and practice, better I am. So let's go back to this concept, then we'll do we have time? Okay, 5 minutes, okay. I will close this now concept that we are not the body. This is chapter 2nd. We are living in the body. This concept gives you an extension of thinking that we are all actors. This world is a stage and you are acting. So do your acting like you see Amitabh Bachchan in the movie.
Perfectly. Without any worry.
Without any strength. And when your
show is over, leave everything.
Because no actor is allowed
to take the costumes home.
He has to leave behind the screen. Because somebody else has to use that. So if you develop that after thinking, lot of toxic thoughts will be released from the mind.
Mind will be stable.
Mind will be peaceful. Our interpersonal relationship will be more stable, more cordial, more respectful.
And that
it is achievable, it is doable, it can be done. People who have done it, they are sharing this wisdom through Srimad Bhagavad Gita that it can be done. It's not difficult, cost effective, time management, everything comes under this concept that you are the actor, you are not the real people. You are just acting. This world is a stage, big stage. Think that way. Think that way. Don't become the owner. Actors are not owners. It is somebody else's money, producer, director is directing them to do like that. Here Bhagavad Gita is giving you the direction. Bhagavad Gita is the director. So follow the direction of the director, which is Srimad Bhagavad Gita. The life, your acting will be more mature, more entertaining. You will entertain yourself and the society. Jai Shri Krishna. We will continue next time.